Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. This is lecture number 16 in Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. We are going to discuss the Rayleigh flow, part 1. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the isentropic flow in the nozzle and diffuser. And we solved problems with the isentropic flow. And we discussed the fan out flow. And we solved a problem in the fan out flow also. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about the Rayleigh flow. We will be defining Rayleigh flow. We will discuss the Rayleigh curve, the significance of Rayleigh curve. We calculate the property variation in the Rayleigh flow. The pressure and temperature we will calculate in this lecture. The remaining properties we will discuss, we will calculate in the next lecture. The learning outcome to the lecture, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to define Rayleigh flow. They will explain, the student will explain the Rayleigh curve and calculate the properties of Rayleigh flow. So Rayleigh flow is one-dimensional, steady, frictionless flow through constant area duct with the heat transfer is known as Rayleigh flow. In the previous lectures, we discussed the isentropic flow. It is highly hypothetical, ideal situation. So there is no friction, there is no heat transfer. That is what isentropic flow. In the second lecture, fan out flow, we discussed the fan out flow where again there is no heat transfer, we have only friction. The Rayleigh flow, the frictional losses are, frictional effects are negligible or neglected, and we discuss with the heat transfer. So it is a one-dimensional, steady, frictionless flow with the constant area duct with the heat transfer is called as Rayleigh flow. But practically in any gas dynamic system, there will be heat transfer, there will be friction, and the real situation, we have the frictional effect and we have to study the heat transfer, with the heat transfer. Because of the friction, there will be heat transfer, and because of the temperature difference also, there will be heat transfer. So in the practical flow, in gas dynamics, there will be, it will be the combination, combined fan out and Rayleigh flow. But to understand the concepts, the basic understanding of the subject, we study the most idealistic situation, isentropic flow. Then we study the effect of friction in the form of fan out flow. And we study the effect of heat transfer in the form of Rayleigh flow. So, one-dimensional, steady, frictionless flow through a constant area duct with the heat transfer is known as Rayleigh flow. The heat transfer process in many heat exchanger and the combustion in steady flow engines are examples of Rayleigh flow. So, wherever the gas is flowing with the heat transfer, the Rayleigh flow principles are applicable. The various assumptions for the Rayleigh flow analysis are, the flow takes place in a constant area duct, the frictional effects are negligible, the gas behaves as perfect gas and the properties are constant. The flow is steady and one-dimensional. The external shaft work and the body forces are absent. They are negligible. These are all the assumptions for the Rayleigh flow. And we derive the Rayleigh, draw the Rayleigh curve or Rayleigh line. So to derive the Rayleigh curve or Rayleigh line, we have to take the governing equation. The first equation is the continuity equation. The continuity equation for steady one-dimensional flow in a constant area duct is given by m dot by a, mass flow rate per unit area. This defined as mass flow density g, which is rho into c. So the mass flow density already we defined the fan out flow also, g equal to rho into c. The momentum equation for one-dimensional frictionless flow with negligible shear and the body forces is given by the impulse function. F equal to Pa into Pa plus rho Ac square is the impulse function, which is the momentum equation for one-dimensional frictionless flow. Rearranging F by A, that is momentum, I mean the impulse function per unit area, F by A equal to P plus rho C square equal to constant, because F by A is constant, momentum is constant. Now substituting the value of C, which is G by rho. So, P in the previous equation, we substitute for C from the previous equation, which is G by rho. So, P plus G squared by rho equal to constant. So, here, the enthalpy, entropy are the two properties we are going to take. So we represent the pressure in terms of enthalpy and entropy, and the density also in terms of enthalpy and entropy. So P is a function of H and S. H is the specific enthalpy, S is the specific entropy. Rho is a function of H and S again. Now when you write the equation, so P, which is a function of H and S, G square is a constant, rho is function of H and S, is equal to a constant C. Now this equation is plotted in the curve by taking enthalpy, specific enthalpy in the y-axis and specific entropy in the x-axis. So this is the plot of the curve, plot of this equation, and this is called as Rayleigh line. So this is the basic line for Rayleigh flow process. So here we have the upper branch of the curve, m is less than 1, that is subsonic condition, and the lower branch of the curve is for the m is greater than 1, which is for supersonic flow, and the m equal to 1, which is the sonic condition. And if you look at the curve, the upper branch of the curve, subsonic flow, the in the direction from left to right, the entropy is increasing, that is for heating process. Entropy increases for heating process. And the reverse process, entropy decreases, it is for the cooling process. Similarly, in the supersonic branch of the lower portion of the supersonic branch of the curve, here again heating and the cooling. So heating, during heating, the entropy increases, and during the cooling, the entropy decreases. So this is what the Fanon line, basic Fanon line, based on which we are going to define the entire process, the various conditions in the subsonic heating, subsonic cooling, supersonic heating and supersonic cooling. We are going to derive the property variation for the two region, and we are going to solve the problem in the Rayleigh flow process. And from the governing equation, we calculate dH by dS, which is dT by dS, because for ideal gases or the gases, H equal to Cp into T. So dH also we can represent in terms of dT. So dT by dS equal to T by Cp, gamma m square minus 1 divided by m square minus 1. And examining this equation, so examining this equation, we will have different conditions. When m is less, m equal to 1, m tends to 1, if we substitute m tends to 1 initially, Mach number subsonic condition, dT by dS tends to infinity. When m is equal to 1 by square root of gamma, so Mach number equal to 1 by square root of gamma, you substitute here, m square equal to 1 by square root of gamma, this become numerator becomes 0, so dT by dS equal to 0. So when m is less than 1 by square root of gamma and greater than 0, then dT by dS equals greater than 0. And similarly, when the m value is less than 1 and greater than 1 by square root of gamma, and dT by dS is less than 0. And similarly here, when m equal to greater than 1, dT by dS equal to greater than 0. So the same equation, the various values of m, we represent in the form of Fanon curve. So in the Fanon curve, with the help of the Fanon curve, we discuss the various Mach number. And this is the point where m equal to 1. Where dT by dS is tends to infinity. And here this is the point where dT by dS equal to 0. So where m equal to 1 by square root of gamma. So dT by dS is the slope of the line horizontally, horizontal line. For horizontal line dT by dS equal to 0, and for vertical line dT by dS tends to infinity. And the flow, now the Rayleigh process occurs only the value, m value less than 1 by square root of gamma. This is for the subsonic region. And the Rayleigh flow occurs only in the lower portion, so less than m equal to 1. So m equal to less than 1, so this value, m is greater than 1, this value, this part, lower branch or subsonic, supersonic region. So the Fanon flow occurs in the upper branch, upper part of the curve for subsonic region, where the Mach number is less than 1 by square root of gamma, in the supersonic region, right, where the Mach number is greater than 1. So this is where the Fanon flow process may occur. So the Rayleigh flow process will occur. So the Rayleigh flow, the heat transfer process will not occur between these two, m equal to 1 and m equal to square root of gamma, because the entropy decreases, dT by dS is decreasing, which is not possible. Less than 0, dT by dS is less than 0. So now listen, so this is the same curve. So the m is less than 1 by square root of gamma, greater than 0. This is this portion of the curve in the subsonic region. dT by dS is greater than 0. m is 1 by square root of gamma, dt by ds equal to 0, and this is the point. M is less than 1 and greater than 1 by square root of gamma, the dt by ds is less than 0 and the small portion of the curve. And m is tends to 1, dt by ds is infinity, and this is the point. And m is greater than 1, dt by ds is greater than 0, and this lower portion of the curve. So the Rayleigh curve for the perfect gas, if we substitute gamma equal to 1.4, we can calculate the m value and we can define a process for a specific particular gas. Now we calculate the property variation for Rayleigh flow. So this is the fluid, so it's a constant area duct. It is insulated, it is frictionless duct and there is heat transfer. We have the supply of heat. So this is section 1. As in the fan of flow, suppose the fluid enters in the subsonic region and the fluid proceeds in the direction, there is heat transfer and m equal to 1, that is what the choking condition, where pressure is P star, temperature is T star, density is rho star, pressure is P star and PO star is the stagnation pressure and TO star is the stagnation temperature. Similarly, the fluid enters here at section 2, where the properties are P2, T2, rho2, PO2, TO2, C2. As it proceeds in the direction of the flow, the Mach number increases and it becomes 1. So if the fluid enters with the subsonic Mach number, the Mach number increases and it reaches the choking condition where m equal to 1. If the fluid enters with the supersonic condition, the Mach number decreases and it reaches m equal to 1, which is the choking condition. Now we calculate the pressure ratio. So from the momentum equation already we defined, F equal to PA plus rho AC square, F by A equal to P plus rho C square, and P plus rho C square equal to constant. So this is equation number 1. Now from the equation of state, rho C square, so rho equal to P by RT and C square is there. So rho C square we are going to replace rho equal to P by RT into C square. So multiplying by gamma, both numerator and denominator, gamma P divided by gamma RT C square. So gamma RT is A square. Gamma RT is A square. C square by A square equal to M square. So rho C square equal to rho C square equal to gamma P into M square. This is the equation, modification. Now simplifying, P into 1 plus gamma M square equal to constant. So this is from the previous equation. So from this equation, so substituting for rho C square, we'll get P into 1 plus gamma m square equal to constant. Now apply this equation for inlet and the outlet condition and rearrange the terms. P1 by P2 equal to 1 plus gamma m2 square divided by 1 plus gamma m1 square. So the pressure ratio equal to 1 plus gamma m2 square divided by 1 plus gamma m1 square. And for choking at the outlet, where m2 equal to 1, P2 equal to P star. So the above equation is reduced to P by P star equal to, substituting m2 equal to 1, p1 plus gamma divided by 1 plus gamma m square, and this is the variation of pressure. P is the pressure at any point for any given Mach number, p star is the pressure for the choking condition where Mach number equal to 1. And we can plot the property variation in the form of a graph. So this is the variation of pressure ratio with respect to Mach number, p by p star equal to 1 plus gamma by 1 plus gamma m square, and the pressure ratio is decreasing for gamma equal to 1.4. So this is the calculation for gamma equal to 1.4. And temperature ratio, applying the equation of state at inlet and the outlet of the duct. So this is the equation of state, P by rho equal to RT. So applying for the inlet and the outlet condition and rearranging, T1 by T2 equal to P1 by P2 into rho 2 by rho 1. Now we substitute for P1 by P2. So from applying the continuity equation at inlet and the outlet condition, rearranging the terms, rho 2 by rho 1 equal to C1 by C2. C1 equal to M1 into square root of gamma RT1. C2 equal to M2 into square root of gamma RT2. This becomes M1 by M2 into square root of T1 by T2. Now we substitute there. So we will get T1 by T2 equal to P1 by P2 into M1 by M2 whole square. So this T1 by T2, substituting here, you will get it. Now, substituting P1 by P2 in this equation, so T1 by T2 equal to M1 square by M2 square into 1 plus gamma m2 square divided by 1 plus gamma m1 square whole square. So, here we have to substitute for P1 and P2. So, we will get the equation. Now, for the choking condition, when m2 equal to 1, T2 become T star, that is a choking condition, and the above equation reduced to T by T star equal to m square, because m2 equal to 1, m square into 1 plus gamma divided by 1 plus gamma m square whole square. And we plot the temperature variation with respect to Mach number. For gamma equal to 1.4, this is how the temperature is changing. We stop here. So, these are all the books I have written in the mechanical engineering subject. And you may find the gas dynamics and jet propulsion book. You can refer to the book for additional information regarding the derivation of various equations. Of course, for solving the problem, the derivation C is not required, because we are going to take the properties as in the final flow, isentropic flow. We are going to take the properties from the gas tables and we are going to solve the problem. Just to understand the property variation with respect to Mach number. So, you can refer to the book for additional information on the subject. And I upload the video lectures of all the of the subject in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the video lectures for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my WhatsApp number or email ID for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again in another video lectures in the Rayleigh flow. We continue in the next lecture, the Rayleigh flow discussion.